Here is a bold statement. Even if you're working with After Effects for many years now, I bet I can show you at least one thing you didn't know. Maybe three things, maybe even more. All right, let's put it to the test. So even if you're an After Effects veteran artist, I'm sure I can show you a few things you didn't know. Some of them will be useful each time you work with the app, others you will never use. But stick around until the end because there's a surprise bonus tip which will make you cry, but in a good way. You probably know that if you double click on a parametric shape, for example, an ellipse shape, After Effects will create it using the layer's dimensions or the comp dimensions, depending on what you are selecting. In this case, I'm using a 16:9 widescreen comp, and if I double click on the ellipse tool, I'm going to get this result, which is great if I want to create a vignette, but this is not what I'm after. So I'll open up the contents of this shape layer and then twirl down the ellipse one until I see the ellipse path. And then I'll disable the Constrain Proportions icon. And now this is the tip, hold down Option, which will be Alt on Windows, and click on the icon again. And notice that After Effects will take the biggest value and place it in both X and Y. This will also convert the rectangles to squares and basically equal every array that has at least two or three dimensions. So now I can reduce the size of this shape and I'll have my perfect circle. There is even a faster way to get symmetrical shapes or masks, even if you are using a landscape or a portrait comp. All you need to do is hold down Shift and then double click on the Shape tool. This is going to create a circle or a square regardless of the comp size and the aspect ratio. So now to this circle I can add the offset path operator, spoil myself with a few duplicates, which will allow me to create a complex articulated animation in seconds. Although the name of the application is After Effects, sometimes you fall in love with your work and add too many effects, so many that you can't see the woods for the trees. Well, if this happens to you, all you need to do is simply select all the relevant layers, then go to Effect and choose Remove All, or use the keyboard shortcut Command or Control Shift E. All the effects are now gone and you can judge the core animation and maybe start over and create a fresh look. If you've seen any of my previous tutorials, you probably already know that you can click and scrub on any color chip in the timeline to cycle between different hues. But did you know that you can also scroll up and down, and this way you can control the saturation? Well, now you know it. By the way, a pro tip, if you'll hold Command Control on the Windows side, you'll move between those colors slower, so you can really fine-tune your selection. Unfortunately, this trick only works in the timeline, so you can't scrub colors in the Effect Controls or the Properties panel. Maybe it will change in the future, who knows? Let's say that you want to add an effect and then animate its values with more control. In this case, I'll add the CC light rays to this adjustment layer, and then I'll move the target to the center of this composition. I'll go to the start and then set keyframes for the radius and warp softness. Then I'll move forward 2 seconds and set these values to 200. Now let's say that I want to keep the same value of 200 until 5 seconds. So I'll go over there and instead of exposing those keyframes in the timeline and edit the value over there, I can just hold down the Option key, Alt on Windows, and click on the name of the value, not the stopwatch, because this will add an expression. So the name of the value in the effect controls, and this will add the existing value at this point in time. Now I can move forward 2 seconds and reset them back to zero. Now I know that you don't believe me, so let me show you what happened behind the scenes. By pressing the letter U, which will show us the keyframes, and then if I press J to move to the previous visible keyframe and then do it a few more times, you can see that these values stayed the same. A minor shortcut that will save you a fraction of a second each time you use After Effects, but by the end of the year, it will accumulate to 5 full minutes. Now, what you can do with these additional 5 minutes, you ask? Well, you can use 10 seconds to like this video and subscribe to the channel, and then the rest of the time you are free to watch more tutorials or just kneel before Zod.
Kneel before Zod!
Totally up to you. Moving on to tip number 6, which is a unique tip just for the curves effect. So I'll add the curves to this adjustment layer. And while the effect is selected, I can press Command 1, this will be Control 1 on the Windows side, to activate only the red channel. I can do some curving here, and then press Command 2 to move to the green channel and modify it on its own. And then of course Command 3 to give some love to the blue channel, and Command 4 will get you the alpha channel, so you can manipulate it as well. Command 0, by the way, is the combination that you want to press to get back to the RGB curves. And from here, you can repeat this dance as many times as you need. How many times you've worked with 3D layers that were modified or rotated and end up with this situation that each one of the axes is showing or pointing the XYZ gizmo in a different direction? This can be tricky to control and understand. So first, make sure to turn the 3D reference axis, which you can find under the grid and guide pop-up menu. This will help you to understand the X, Y, and Z directions in the entire comp. Then I highly recommend that you will switch to the world axis mode, which will make all the 3D gizmo indicators point at the same direction. Meaning X is always left or right, Y is up or down, and Z, Z or Zod is always away or closer to you. And you know what it means, right?
Kneel before Zod!
Another cool utility mode in After Effects is the comparison view. So in this case, I'll open the astronaut composition that I've created using Midjourney. And let's say that I want to match the scale of this 2D astronaut to the 3D model that I have in the main composition. So I can click on the camera icon to take a snapshot, or if you are really serious about it, or maybe just bored, you can also press Shift F5. Then I'll return to my main comp, go to the beginning and press F5 to toggle between the snapshot and this frame. However, if you hold down the Option key, Alt on Windows, and press on the Show Snapshot icon, then you can see the image superimposed using the Difference Blending mode, which is just a temporary thing that can help you compare between the two. So black means there's no difference between those two images, and in this case, I'm not after pixel perfect matching, I just want to change the astronaut size to match it with the original AI creation. So I can select and scale this layer up a touch and then do the comparison again. By the way, After Effects have 4 snapshot bank memory, so you can press Shift F6, Shift F7 and Shift F8 to store additional stills and then call them again by pressing F5 to F8 accordingly. Here is a cool trick that will help you to see and control all the 3D layers in your composition. So I'm midst animating this lovely scene, And it looks promising. However, I want to make sure that I'm not missing anything or maybe leaving something behind. So I'll go to the last frame and then I'll choose View, Look at all layers. Oh, what do you know? There's another layer over here of a broken moon that I totally ignored. Okay, so I'll undo, because when you use this command, it will actually change the camera position that you have in the comp. So just be mindful that this can be your friend or your enemy. But now that I'm aware of this 3D model, I can change its position and include it in this scene. By default, After Effects is showing you a thumbnail of the first frame of your composition in the project panel. Now, depending on the content that you are creating, this may not be the most helpful image to see. In this case, for this composition, we can see it's pitch black. So I'll open this comp and move to 1 second, and then I'll choose Set Poster Time from the composition menu. Then I'll deselect and reselect the comp icon in the project panel, and I can see my new thumbnail. While we are here, here is a tip inside the tip. So from the flowout menu of the project panel, I'll select Thumbnail Transparency Grid, and this is going to show us the alpha checkerboard in the little thumbnail icon. Arguably, this is the best chime in the world. The render is finished. But where is it? I need to use it back in this project, but I don't remember where I placed it. Well, of course, I can have a look under the file path and then trace it back from there, or even click on it to see the file and bring it back to the project. But you can also click and drag the word's output module from the render queue panel, and the file will be imported back to the project.
Hello.
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 Okay, for my last trick, I'll need a volunteer from the crowd. Who wants to join me on the stage? Why, no one? Alright, so I'll do it myself. I'll create a new composition with the most common name in the history of After Effects, which is of course Comp1. Then I'll open the Sound Effects folder under the animation presets that ships with After Effects. And finally, I'll double click on this one, Call Adobe. A new solid will be created with the tone effect, and if I'll preview it, you can hear the numbers tone of the support line of Adobe. Now, this is a real deal. I'm not sure how you would use this dial tone with a modern equipment, but I'm sure someone can explain it for everyone in the comments below. Once we learn how to do it, we can all troll Adobe and open support tickets directly from After Effects. I guess if it's here, we might as well put it to good use. So I hope that some of what I showed you can help you in your own work. Please let me know in the comments below how many of these hidden gems you didn't know. Thank you so much for sticking until the end, and I will see you again in the next one.